Christmas. Welcome to Night of Hope 2021. We started doing these concerts 8 years ago to benefit the widows and orphans in our church and our community. As you can imagine, the holidays are difficult for these families who have lost a loved one. And unfortunately, the list of these families is growing, especially during this time. And I'm so grateful to see all of you that are here tonight to celebrate with us Christmas, to celebrate with us at this concert, to enjoy good music, and to benefit those families who are in need.
Every single It's no secret that the last few years have been tough. God is not surprised. It didn't catch him by surprise what's taking place. And there's a lot of things in our world that we can be discouraged about or lose hope. The awesome thing about Christmas and the awesome thing about God, thousands of years before the birth of Christ, God promised, he said, a child will be born to you, son will be given to you, and his name, and not just his name, his title, and not just his title, who he will be the Prince of Peace. I pray for you tonight. I pray that you find this peace. If your heart is broken, if your heart is hopeless, if your heart is discouraged, I pray you find this peace. He is the Prince of Peace, and the peace he gives, it lasts forever. In spite of circumstances, in spite of everything around us, his peace will hold us through anything that happens around us or even in our own life. I pray you find peace. I pray he will become your Prince of Peace, even this year, this Christmas.
Joy to the world on a night like no other, Emmanuel. God is with us, beggars and kings, let us bow and adore him, rest in his peace.
Was born to conquer the grave. questo giorno che ricorderai. Alzati in fretta e vai. C'è chi crede in te, non ti arrendere.
Long lay the world in sin and His law is love, and His gospel is peace. Chains shall He break for the slave, His our brother, and in His name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise, we let all within praise His holy name.
What is hope? It is a joyful expectation of the future, a desire for something good to happen, to trust, to wait patiently, expectantly. It is expecting something to happen because God said so. It's not wishing. It's not even the term we use, hoping. It says about Abraham, when Abraham had no reason to hope, he kept on hoping, believing that he would become a father of many, because God said that to him. And his faith did not waver, even at 100 years old. He believed because God said so. He said, you will have a baby, you will have a son. And even his wife, he had to encourage his wife to believe. And it says, Abraham never wavered in believing God's promises. In fact, his faith grew stronger. And by this, he brought glory to God, because he was fully convinced that God is able to do whatever he promised. He hoped. And it came to pass.
Ding dong, it don't matter, it's a song with joyful ring, all caroling.
a son is given. God with us, go and tell Emmanuel has come from heaven.
Unto us a child is born, for a child is born to us. A son is given us, The government will be upon his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. We do not hope in an idea. We do not hope in a philosophy. We do not hope in a person. We hope in Jesus. He is the one who created all things, and yet he came down to his creation. A king became a slave. And for what purpose? So we would put our faith in him. To put our hope in him, we will not be disappointed.
The timeless theme, earth and heaven will pass away. It's not a dream. God will make all things new that day. Gone is the curse from which I stumbled and fell. Evil is banished to eternal hell. No more night, no more pain, no more tears, never cry again, and praises to the great I am. We will live in the light of the risen Lamb. The nations bow down to see. The only sound is the praises to Christ, our King. Slowly the names from the book are crying again, and praises to the great I am. We will live in the light of the risen Lamb. See, over there, there's a mansion.
Jesus, Jesus, who walks Oh, come let us adore him. That's what the shepherds said the original Night of Hope 2021 years ago. Oh, come let us adore him. That's what the wise men said the original Night of Hope 2021 years ago. Oh, come let us adore him. That's what those who realized what had happened at that moment were saying 2021 years ago. I would encourage each one of us right now to just take a moment to pause and realize that the fact of Christ's birth is a historically confirmable fact. It is not a confirmable fact that some mythical figure who flies around on a Christmas day and delivers all the gifts. We don't have any archaeological evidence for that. However, when we look at the personhood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, this is a historically, archaeologically verifiable fact. I want to just encourage each and every one of us this evening to take a moment and to realize that when we say it's a night of hope, we're not saying a night of just close your eyes and maybe jump into the dark and leap into something, maybe, hopefully something's out there. We're not talking about something that might or might not, but we really hope that it exists. We're talking about something that we can know as a fact is for sure. Anno Domini. If you don't know any Latin words, now you do. Anno Domini. We live in 2021 AD. Anno Domini means in the year of our Lord, in the year that Christ was born. And so for now, 2021 reiterations of that celebration, today we celebrate once again that night of hope that originally occurred so many years ago. But when we look at the statistics, even today, unfortunately, it seems there is a contradiction between the facts of our day and the hope that we're celebrating. Why is it that during this time of the year, suicide rates spike? Why is it that this time of year, there are so many people suffering with depression? Why is it that in this season of what should be hope, so many people are in the lowest points of their life? And many perhaps have lost their loved ones. I want to share a story of a woman by the name of Corrie ten Boom. She lived about 70 years ago, and it just so happened that she lived in a place and in a time when Jews were being rounded up and sent to concentration camps. Being a Christian, she said, "No, I will not stand on the wayside when this horrible thing is happening. I will allow God to use me to save as many souls and save as many lives as I could." And so what she did was she hid the Jews in her own home until, unfortunately, she herself was discovered by the Gestapo. When she was brought to the concentration camp herself, she made a commitment in her heart that she will be a representation of Christ's love and Christ's hope in that very camp to those very Jews. She was determined not to allow the very horrendous and dark circumstances to taint her witness of Christ. And she wrote something very interesting on Christmas Eve in that concentration camp. This is what she said. This is what she wrote. "Who can add to Christmas? The perfect motive is that God so loved the world. The perfect gift is that he gave his only son. The only requirement is to believe in him. The reward of faith is that you shall have everlasting life." These words were written from a Nazi concentration camp. I want to encourage each one of us that hope is not wishful thinking. No, it is not just something that we want and really hope is true. When we see the lives of people like Corrie ten Boom and the lives of actually so many Christians living in this city today, we realize that the hands and the feet of Jesus Christ are still alive and still active today. That the body of Jesus Christ that was crucified on the cross is not simply gone and forgotten. His hands and his feet are being used by those who've been transformed by his power and his love. And so this night of hope, this night that we celebrate that original night of hope, I want to encourage every single one of us. If perhaps you're going through tough times, challenging times, especially perhaps if you've lost a loved one, a parent, a son, a daughter, maybe a brother, sister, or another close loved one, that there is hope. And that hope is alive, and his name is Jesus. And that hope is active through those who are Christ and who's been transformed by Christ. And I also want to encourage each one of us to allow God to use us, our hands, our feet, to be a representation of his living hope to the world. Merry Christmas. God bless you all. And let's be that hope that came 2021 years ago in Bethlehem.
Family hiding from the storm, found no place at the keeper's door. It was for this a child was born, to save a world so cold and hollow. The sleeping town, they did not know that lying in a manger low, a Savior King who had no home has come to heal our sorrows. Is there room in your heart? Is there room in your heart? Is there room in your heart for God to write his story?
But it
before the birth of Jesus, even before there was no room for Joseph and for Mary to find a place to give birth to the child that was promised, before she even knew that she was pregnant, the angel appeared to Mary and said, "Mary, you will have a child and you are to give him a name. You give him the name Jesus." And Jesus means that he will save the world from their sin. What sin? What Savior? Why Jesus? Jesus is a Savior of the world. That's the reason and that's the purpose why he came. He came to save us. He came to save you. Is there room in your heart to receive him, to receive his salvation? We might say, "Oh, I'm good enough. I didn't do anything wrong." But the Bible says the standard of God is perfection, holiness, purity. And none of us can say that we have attained that on our own. That's why we all need a Savior. I need a Savior every day. Maybe you need a Savior tonight. Is there room in your heart to ask the Savior to come into your life, into your family, and save you from even yourself, myself? I need salvation from sin. I need salvation from myself. And the whole challenge, the whole concept, or the whole idea behind celebrating the birth of Christ is to make sure that we are okay with God. Make sure that the sin issue is resolved. Make sure that the Savior who came into the world to save us saved me. And it's easy. Salvation doesn't require us to do a lot of good things. Salvation doesn't even require us to go to church. For us to be saved, it's as easy. We've broken it down to as simple as ABC. A, admit that you're a sinner. I'm a sinner. I've done a lot of wrong things to meet the standard of God's holiness. B, believe in your heart that Jesus came into this world to die for my sin, to take the punishment of my sin before a holy God. He died on the cross to take my consequences. And confess. Confess means just I say that I believe. I tell Jesus that I believe that you came into this world and you died for me. It's simple. You can just pray it in your heart. Say, "Jesus, I know that I'm a sinner. I believe that Jesus came and died on the cross for my sin. I accept his sacrifice for myself, for my sin. Now help me to live a holy life and follow after you." If you said that, if you believe that with all of your heart, the Bible says you will be saved. And if you're saved, you have hope, you have peace, and you have joy. And not just in this lifetime, because our life does not end here. It goes on after we die. To have this joy, to have this peace, and to have this hope, it helps us every day of our life.
Did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know? This child that you deliver will soon deliver you. Mary, Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? And when you kiss your little baby, you've kissed the face of God. Oh, Mary, did you know?
There is no other name.
The name of Jesus is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and they are not afraid. If there was another name that we could be saved by, if there was another person that can save us from our sins, we would be speaking that name tonight. But there is no other name, the name of Jesus, a Savior of the world, a Savior for us and a Savior for you. The name of Jesus is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and they are not afraid. Jesus, He will save His people from their sins. Such a great and joyous celebration, such a wonderful opportunity to know that name and to be saved. I'm sorry, Fauci's not going to save you. The government's not coming to save you. They can't even take care of themselves. But for us as Christians, we have a hope and we have a sure foundation. The Bible says that this hope, it's an anchor for our soul. No matter what the storms around us are raging or what's going on in the world around us, we have a hope. We can hold on to this hope because what God has promised, He will fulfill. Folks, this is just the beginning. We're not even done yet. This worship will continue on in eternity, and we're just practicing. We're just getting ready. Sorry if you don't like music. Well, if you don't like music, you probably wouldn't be here, but I'm just excited that we're just getting started. We will spend all of eternity worshiping the one who saved us from our sins. I feel bad, and it breaks my heart to know that there's people around us who are dying without Christ, and I'm sorry, their goodness is not going to save them. And it breaks my heart and I cry knowing that they are separated for all of eternity without Christ. This message, this hope we have tonight to share this good news that the Savior of the world has come to save us. Let us rejoice. I love what the angels told the shepherds out in the field on that first Bethlehem. That first Christmas was not easy. It was bad. People had trials, people had trouble, but the angels said, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news. In the city of David, a Savior has been born to you this day." And they were excited to run to this manger and to find the baby, Jesus, lying in the manger. And then the shepherds worshiped, and then the wise men came and they worshiped. I hope that we can worship God tonight to say, "Jesus, thank you for coming into this world. Thank you for saving me. Forgive me for just focusing on everything else that's around me, for being discouraged, for being sad when I have this joy of knowing that you came into this world to save me and you provided everything I need for this life and the life to come." Let's worship Him tonight.
The Father's love begotten, ere the world began to be. He the source of all that has been, and all the future years will see. Evermore, evermore, He shall reign.
Chosen verse. On behalf of Missionary Gospel Church, we'd like to express a huge gratitude to everyone who made this event, Night of Hope, possible. Thank you so very much. To all our sponsors, to all our organizers of this beautiful event yesterday and tonight, to everybody who's been involved in stage setup, lighting, to all our media team, to our sound operators, to those who work on cameras, photographers. We want to say big thank you to our choir conductors, to all the musicians that came here tonight and yesterday, to all the choir members, to all the worship groups, to all singers. Thank you. It was beautiful. It's amazing. Are we here at Missionary Gospel Church? Praise God. We want to say thank you to everyone who joined us here tonight and for those who've been here for a couple days. And if you like it, we're going to continue our Christmas celebration tomorrow. We'll have two morning services at 9 a.m. and 11:30 a.m. And we'll have our teen choir singing tomorrow morning. And then the next Sunday, we are going to have our youth choir singing. So join us. Welcome to our family. May God bless you. Christmas is here. We are celebrating Christmas already. And may God be with you. May His peace, His love, and His hope that He truly brought to this earth be in your homes and most of all, in your hearts. And before we sing the final song, I'd like to invite Pastor Valentin here as well to join me on the stage. And we're going to, most of all, thank God for His love that He showed to us, to the mankind, to the humanity. He came to this earth, and that's why we're here tonight celebrating Christmas. And He'll lead us in prayer.
Pastor, I liked it so much that I was here yesterday, and I came back for more today. Thank you for being here. Just one thought that I want to leave with you guys. This is the generation of people, or maybe a previous generation of my parents, that were told that, hey, that the country that we were living in, the system that we were living and raised, basically, we had no future. And this is what I was told in the school. You have no future, or your future is very dull. And then when I was here last night, and I was sitting right there, I thought about this. And I thought, how could this possible when people were predicting what our future is going to look like? And this is what we have to offer right now. It's because of God, because of the Emmanuel, because God is with us. Amen.
Falls, yet nothing's really changed. Eden's promise feels like it's a million miles away. The endless span from God to man grows wider every day. The price too great for mortal man to pay. Yet in the darkness see Messiah's guiding light.
Star of mercy shining like a diamond pure and bright. Every beam that falls to earth helped declare this noble birth. Healing comes as Mary's baby cries. This is a night of hope. It's a night of joy. This is a night of peace. Wrapped in a baby born. This holy child of promise has come to live. Watch the sheep, the world lies fast asleep, all unaware the prince of priests has crossed the gulf between. Created king, ancient of days, in a lonely manger lay. Now for the man can once again be free. Oh sacred night, oh glorious night, oh holy night divine. Faith now restored, be now
for coming. Merry Christmas. Have a pleasant holiday season. Happy New Year. May God be with you and bless you and keep you.